As of the week of December 10th, 2023, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is Nicaragua's Masaya volcano, which long ago was searched by conquistadors who thought that gold lied buried within its active lava lake. While they of course did not find any gold, it is a reminder that this volcano has maintained an active lava lake for much of the last 500 years. While its current eruption is almost completely effusive with occasional minor ash emissions, the presence of a caldera indicates that thousands of years ago, Masaya produced far more powerful and explosive eruptions. And now, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In the nation of Tonga, right after the recently formed volcanic island of Home Reef ceased erupting, new activity was detected at another shallow submarine volcano a mere 23 kilometers to the south-southwest. Meanwhile, in Japan, a new underwater caldera was discovered, which was likely the source of two highly unusual mystery tsunamis that struck much of the country on October 3rd and October 9th. And in what is this week's top story, Indonesia's Marapi volcano produced an unusually long pyroclastic flue, which scorched more than 5 square kilometers of its southwestern flank. For context, I am not referring to the Marapi volcano with two A's, but instead the Merapi volcano with one A. Merapi is a far more dangerous volcano than Marapi, since it has historically produced several subplanetary and planetary eruptions, the last of which occurred in 2010, generating a 17.1-kilometer or 11-mile-long pyroclastic flue, which struck a highly populated area. Since this eruption, Merapi has largely contained two simultaneously growing lava domes, the central dome within its summit crater, and the southwest dome on the upper southwestern slope of the volcano. Each of these domes produce frequent partial collapses which generate pyroclastic flows that descend separate sectors of the volcano. While both of these lava domes are still probably growing, recent activity has largely been concentrated at the southwestern dome. However, on December 8th, heavy rainfall fell on the mountain which seeped into the still erupting viscous lava flow. Seeping in between cracks, the heat of the lava caused the water to expand via flashing to steam, which pushed the lava dome rapidly downwards. Eventually, what may have been more than a million cubic meters of the lava dome collapsed, releasing superheated gas that had built up, generating a pyroclastic flow. This pyroclastic flow descended several southwest sector drainages where it traveled up to 5,230 meters away and scorched a total of 5.1 square kilometers of the mountain. Because this lava dome is still potentially unstable, the next few days to weeks could see more collapses and pyroclastic flows strike the southwestern slopes of Mount Merapi. Meanwhile, in Japan, scientists may have finally solved what exactly caused two mysterious tsunamis that struck on October 3rd and October 9th. It was fairly obvious that some form of a deep volcanic eruption had occurred and was related to two moderate magnitude earthquakes that preceded the tsunamis. Well, scientists discovered a brand new volcanic caldera at the exact point source of these tsunamis, which measures 6 kilometers wide. The thought is that these tsunamis were generated by what is referred to as trapped or faulting on a caldera, which is caused when uneven strain and pressure is placed on overlying caldera ring faults due to the movement of magma until it slips and generates an earthquake that uplifts overlying water, thus generating a tsunami. In the nation of Tonga, beginning on November 9th, an increased amount of submarine gas emissions were seen being emitted from the Late Iki volcano, which is just west-southwest of the Home Reef volcano which only recently ceased erupting. For several weeks, this volcano had been emitting bright green and light blue plumes, suggesting that either a submarine volcanic eruption is actively ongoing, or that increased volcanic gas is being released from its fumaroles. Since these emissions are continuing to increase, it may only be a matter of time before this dacite lava dome island produces an eruption on the surface. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on December 9th of 2023. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.